Okay, so today I'm going to show you how to use MATLAB Simulink to simulate a simple circuit. This is the MATLAB icons. This is a Linux system, so if you use the Windows or Mac, it may look a bit different. So I click this MATLAB, it opens the window. And this is the Simulink library that we are going to use for the circuit simulation. If you click this, it will show the Simulink library window. Don't mind this error message, because there's some setup is wrong on my computer, but you might not get this message here. So this is the Simulink library browser. Or you could get the same Simulink library browser using different methods. Instead of clicking this icon, you could type Simulink in the command window of MATLAB. Then you will get this windows popping out. Once you got this, to make a working space, we click this button. It show popping up new windows. So this area is the area we are working for the making a circuit. So we are going to use the Simscape in here. Click this, expand. There's a foundation library. Click that. There's an electrical. Click that. Then we are going inside the electrical elements. First, we get this electrical reference. This is the ground to measure the voltage. So that's the voltage reference point. We need also DC voltage source, so I'll click the electrical source. This is the DC voltage source. Get there, and we connect this minus end to the ground. Now I'm going to add one resistor, going to the electrical element. There's the resistor here. You can rotate this using the click the left button or right button, the other button in the mouse, and this is saying the rotate and clockwise, and I connect this side to the plus end and this minus side of resistor to the ground. If you double click the DC voltage source, it shows that the voltage provided is 1 volt. Let's change it to the 1.2. And this is you can change the unit from volt to different millivolt or kilovolt. So let's set it as a volt. So we provide 1.2 volt, apply, close that, and resistor, we will double click it. Currently it's set to 1 ohm. Let's leave it as it is. Now I want to measure the voltage drop across this resistor. So I'm going to the electrical sensor. This is the voltage sensor. Click drop here. This side connect to that side, and this minus end connect to here. This is the port showing the measured voltage. Going to to actually see this value of the voltage, going into the Simulink, not in the Simscape, but Simulink. This is all the collection of the general blocks. If you go to the sync, there's a block name called display. This shows the numbers that measured from this voltage source, voltage sensor. But if you try to connect it, you cannot really connect it. The reason is because this voltage is the physical signal, and this display is coming from the general Simulink block. So this is just a number to show. So we need some conversion block from physical signal to the just a Simulink number. Going to the Simscape again, there's in the bottom there's a utilities. Here's the PS to Simulink converter. PS stands for the physical signal. So we place there, connect here, and connect there. Then this display will show the voltage drop across this resistor. Let's change its name as voltage. And if you simulate, this is the execution block to run the simulation. And this is the final time, simulate from 0 to 10 seconds at the moment. But 10 seconds might be too long. Let's set it as 1 second. if you click that, it will show the error signal, error occurs. It says that no soluble block connected to physical network. The reason is because that whenever you use this SimScape to simulate the circuit, you need to place one block here called the soluble configuration here. This soluble configuration could be connected anywhere, but let's connect to the ground here. If you double click this soluble configuration, it says there are a bunch of options to set, like a start, whether you start simulation from steady state or what soluble you are going to use to solve this circuit. But don't worry about this too much. Just what you need to know is that you have to put this soluble configuration block and connect to the ground. Let's now try to simulate that. Now, as you can see, this is 1.2 volt drops. Therefore, we see the 1.2 from the screen display. But if you go into the MATLAB command window here, we have two warnings. First warning says that your soluble is not recommended. Your system is stiff. But the recommended soluble is the one OD23T or OD15S. This setting can be done in this button. If you click this button, it will show the Simulink setup. And here's currently soluble is OD45. We can change it to the OD23 or 15S. Let's use the 15S. And then second warning, it says that the default maximum step size is 0.02, and because this currently maximum step size set as auto, so let's set this as an explicit number. So you have to put 10^-3. So maximum step size of this circuit simulation is 0.001, and click apply, close that. If you simulate one more, now it's everything runs fine, we didn't get any warning. So if you change the register to different thing, different value, like reduce the 10 times smaller, if you click that, still the voltage is 1.2. Of course, no matter what register is changed, the voltage provided by the DC voltage source is 1.2, so this value should be always 1.2. How about the current? To measure the current, we need the current sensor going to the SimScape, and here's the electrical sensors. This is the current sensor. To measure the current, you have to cut the line. So this line is cut, and this plus connected to there, minus connected to here. Now we need again change the physical signal to the Simulink and the display. I just copy and paste of this. Paste, and this one should be connected to the current source, the current sensor, and let's change its name from voltage 1 to current. Let's change back the register to 1 ohm, and if you simulate that, you can see the current is 1.2 ampere. If you reduced the resistance 100 times less, then you would have 100 more current will flow, because it's 120, because this voltage source is ideal voltage source. So if you increase the resistance, you have a smaller current, which is in this case 0.012. So this is it. So now you I'd like to ask you to try modify this circuit with the internal resistor for the more realistic DC voltage source simulation.